cross that you have carried. Thank you for your blood that was shed. Took the weight of sin upon your shoulders. Sacrificed your life so I could live. Thank you for the cross that you have carried. Thank you for your blood that was shed. You took the weight of sin upon your shoulders, sacrificed your life so I could live. Now nothing is holding me back from you, Redeemer of my soul. Now nothing can hold me back from you. Your love will never let me go. Thank you for your death and resurrection. Thank you for the power of your blood. I am overwhelmed by your affection, the kindness and the greatness of your love, the kindness and the greatness of your love. Now nothing is holding me back from you.
Never let me go.
So gracious tempest in the sea. Your love is like a storm. Let your tide of mercy rain and let it flood my heart again. Surround me like an ocean, 'cause your love is crashing over me. It's surging like a raging sea. Immerse me in the wonder of your love. The downpour of unending grace, consuming all my reckless ways. My sins submerged, your love has saved. Like a raging sea, immerse me in the wonder of your love. The downpour of unending grace, consuming all my reckless ways. My sins submerged, your love has saved my soul. Flood my heart again. Surrender. crashing over me. It's surging like a raging sea. Immerse me in the wonder of your love. The downpour of unending grace, consuming all my reckless ways. My sins submerged, your love has saved my soul. Surround me like a storm.
Dive into
Christ in teach my soul to rise to you. When temptation comes my way, and when I cannot stand or fall on you, Jesus, you're my hope and stay. For teach my song to rise to you. When temptation comes my way, when I cannot stand or fall on you, oh Jesus, you're my hope and stay. And Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Lord, I need you. your mercy. How great is your mercy. How great is your mercy. That you don't give me as I deserve. Your mercy. Thank you.
Father, so nice to be in your presence. where it's filled with freedom, fear-free, anxiety-free, troubles-free. No slavery can stand in your presence, Father. No fear can stand in your presence. Nothing can stand in your presence that does not glorify you. But we gather here to experience your freedom, to meet you face to face. And if there is anything worth time, anything worth efforts, anything worth trying again and again, anything that is of value, Father, it's relationship with you, is to know you, to be known by you. We believe as we come near, you come near to us as well. We believe that you're a rewarder of those who seek you, and we believe that you're here with us. Thank you, Father. To you be the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, we will transition into a time of intercession for Israel. Earlier this month, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu started a Bible study at his house. As he said himself, he's looking for wisdom and answers. As Israeli leader revived this great tradition, we pray that the whole nation will also seek for wisdom and answers in the Bible, and the Word of God will lead them towards Jesus, our Savior. Father, I thank you that you move as we pray for Israel, and you change circumstances and change hearts. I pray that you stir up greater hunger in the hearts of your people in Israel, that they will be drawn to your wisdom that is hidden in your word, that they will have greater hunger to know you as their God. I pray that as they read and study your word, Holy Spirit will speak to them and show them things they have never seen before. I ask that you would speak to them in new ways, ways that they never experienced before, Father, and you make the word alive and active in their hearts, powerful enough to save and transform them. Help them to see that all scripture and all prophecies point into Jesus, our Savior. Let's pray. Thank you. Father, I pray that you lift the veil over the eyes of your people and that you enlighten the eyes of their hearts in order to know you, to know your will, and to know your Son, Jesus, who died for all of us, and to know fullness of your salvation that is provided and paid for in full already. Now and today is the day of salvation, the time of God's favor. I pray, Father, that the Holy Spirit, as the great teacher, will teach them and guide them into all truth. Guide them into fullness of your love. Release grace for them to overcome all the pride and religious traditions as they encounter you. Help them not to doubt and not to turn their faces away from the truth in favor of traditions of their fathers. I pray that Holy Spirit will grow the seeds of the word in their hearts and it will lead to faith and salvation in Jesus. We release the saving power of the Holy Spirit, saving power of your word, God. We release revelations of the truth about who Jesus is. Let's pray. Father, as you made us one flock with your chosen people, grafted us in one of the same olive tree, and you made us one nation, I pray that dividing walls of hostility between Jews and Christians will be broken. I pray against fear, against anger, against confusion, against misunderstanding in the hearts of your chosen people. I pray that we will be united by one spirit in one body, which is the body of Christ. I pray that all the Jews who came to know Jesus and became Christians will be a bridge and agents of that reconciliation, bringing us to one faith in Jesus. Let's pray. Father, I pray for the Christians and for all your holy church of Jesus Christ in Israel. I declare greater manifestation of your glory, greater manifestation of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, so that the gospel will be backed up by great miracles and personal encounters with you, rather than with arguments of logic and human wisdom. I pray that the church will expand and move in power as in the days of all early church. I prophesy life-changing personal encounters with you, Jesus. Thousands of healings, deliverances, miracles, and wonders as you did through first apostles. We pray that you do the same and much more through your people in Israel. And all this will be to expand your kingdom and the knowledge of you and your Son, Jesus Christ, for your glory, Father. Let's pray. Thank you. Father, we are praying for the revival in your holy nation. Revival like the one you empowered 2,000 years ago, when gospel was spreading unstoppably with miracles and wonders, when hundreds of people were added to church daily. We declare greater hunger for you and the gift of your salvation that comes through Jesus. We bind any hostility toward the gospel among your people in Israel. Thank you, Father, that you let us be your partners in the great things that you do. All these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let heaven access to heaven. And in your name we can ask, and we will receive, we will see, we will hear. We thank you that you've opened the floodgates of heaven over us, that you've invited us to boldly approach your throne of grace. Lord, we ask more grace, more glory, more presence. And we ask that through us, your Son Jesus will be glorified, O God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you all for coming out on this Thursday evening and joining us. We hope and pray that it was a good time opening up Isaiah 60 and just pressing in at the Lord's presence. We invite you to come out next Wednesday morning. We also have a watch 9:30 a.m. as well as again next Thursday evening at